Hi everyone. I look for a lot of the different secrets and mysteries from all around the world, looking for the coming of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, Emmanuel, the Son of God, who was raised from the dead and took all the sins of the world away. Now the world elite, the Illuminati, the Freemasons, and even the spiritual realms that are all around us, they leave their signs and secrets right in front of us, and symbolism. And on our channel, we bring all of this back to the Word of God and show how we're nearing the end of days. Well, today we're going to take a look at this new movie that is coming out called The Maze Runner, and it will be out on September 19th. One of the things I wanted to show in here was that maybe some people don't know that, like, this maze represents part of the underworld, and that the Mayans actually even practiced doing something like this. It was actually called a C-note, just like the $100 bill is seen as a C-note. Well, this looks like a pretty good movie, so let's go ahead and watch the trailer through here, and then we will connect in how that this represents the end of days, and the time when grace and mercy is over with, and now the wages of sin are death. Basically, the way to heaven is blocked.
Can you tell me anything about yourself? Who you are? Where you came from? Can you tell me your name?
I can't remember anything.
Day one, Greeny. Rise and shine.
What is this place?
Welcome to the Glade.
Who put us here?
We don't know.
What's through there?
You guys can't just keep me here.
I can't let you leave.
Why won't you tell me what's out there?
It's the maze. Every morning when those doors open, the runners look for a way out. And no one has ever survived a night in the maze.
What happens to them?
We call them grievers.
We don't belong here.
Somebody built the maze. I think it's time we find out what we're really up against.
You're not like the others. You're curious.
What the hell is that?
This is the first real clue you found.
Who knows where this might lead us?
It's a girl.
Thomas.
Everything started changing the moment you showed up.
What if we were sent here for a reason?
The doors aren't closing.
They're here.
They're gonna keep coming back until they kill us all.
We get out now, or we die trying.
You don't get it. We're already dead.
Well, it looks like a very interesting movie through there, but they're trying to map out the maze as they're going through here. This represents in the Bible the time when the bottomless pit is opened, and then there's no more grace and mercy. This same maze is attributed to what Jesus Christ had to go through in the underworld while he was in the realm of the dead, and when he went down to the place of fear through here. In this movie, they're having to run through during the day, and at the nighttime, the doors shut, and basically the beast has been released inside of the maze. The beast seems to like the darkness. He represents the darkness, the opposite of the light. Well, they did the same thing during the Mayan times. During the Mayan times, they had a thing that was trying to map out the realm of the dead. They called it Xibalba, right here. And they actually went through what was known as C-notes. You see down here in the underworld, and they actually mapped out all of these different things. See here? All different things about the realms of the dead. The Xibalba right here represents the place of darkness. It actually involves the Milky Way. we on the Earth are considered to be in what is the lower half of the Milky Way, and then the upper half is considered to be ascension, and right in the middle is what's considered to be the dark rift. And all of these individuals live in that place of fear known as the dark rift. This is the Milky Way right here. You can see the dark rift is part of this middle. See the dark rift right here? Just like this. And we are supposed to go up and through towards ascension. And this is always like the Earth has a mirror image of these things going on. Just like going into the underworld is like going through this realm of the dead, which is also has to do with things of fear. Now, this is even in the movies again. Pinhead from the show Hellraiser, right here, one of his names is Zipe Totec, and he's actually from Zigbaba. He represents the beast that is going to be released from the bottomless pit. And this thing preys on fear. This is even shown in many of the movies, just like the last Green Lantern movie. They had to stop something that was eating and feeding on fear. Exactly as in the show that everybody has talked about before, which is the Fifth Element with Bruce Willis. A big dark object was coming from outer space that fed on fear and torment. Him, right here, from this dark Zigbaba thing. And it's actually called a C-note. See these C-notes right here? They did the same thing by the Mayan pyramids. They did the same thing as they're doing in this Maze Runner. They sent people down into the underworld and they had them map out all of the different things that were going on in the underground through here, just like this. Just like right here at Chichen Itza. Chichen Itza is where one of the main pyramids is, right over here in Mexico. Here we go. See the Chichen Itza? Like the chicken eats you. This is what it means. The chicken. If you're chicken, you're going to get eaten. You can have no fear. If you have any fear whatsoever, you get consumed by what is inside of the abyss through there. Here is right where the pyramid was. You see the C note? Right over here? This is what the $100 bill really represents. Also, these are not mistakes. This spiritual stuff is all over the world. Just as trying to think that Jesus Christ is only about Jerusalem is foolhardy. That's part of us growing up. We have to realize that it says in the Bible, Jesus Christ and the Father created all of the universe, and not one thing was made that was not made by them. That they created everything. Even all of these Mayan things will have some links to this with the fallen angels and such. Many people don't even know where Satan is. They don't even realize that he's actually still loose and things until he's cast down. Let's show this right here. This is simple too. Watch. Watch this. Book of Enoch. The devil asked for respite. I spelled that wrong. Sorry. See here? It's right here in Wikipedia. All of the world doesn't read this. The Book of Enoch contains references to Satarel, like Saturn, thought also to be Satan. He was to be cast out of heaven, and he asked for respite until the day of judgment. So he is not cast down, and then the other angels are released on the day of judgment. It's all in the Bible. It's right here. He will fall as lightning on that day. When the devil falls, we will see it as lightning. I've even tracked it and shown he'll fall right in San Diego by the 33-degree parallel. And that's when the beginning of the end will come. That's why even the San Diego Chargers are known as the lightning bolt. Revelation 12 is when Michael stands up. And there was war in heaven. Michael and his angels fought against the dragon. And the dragon fought and his angels and prevailed not. Neither was their place found any more in heaven. And the dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceived the whole world. He was cast out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him. And that's when he starts doing the new world order. A great deception comes upon the earth right there, just as we've seen. And this is why he, the devil, has been practicing trying to get through this realm of the dead. He has been practicing with his angels even to try to get through all of this stuff, to try to ascend again. But this stuff is right in front of us. Look there. There's C-note right there. See right here? One, two. They actually went underground here. See how it's underground? See, they all go down underneath here. Then they swam through the bottom of this to get to what they considered to be the underworld. And then they would practice and they would map out the way. Jesus Christ is the only one that has made it through, and he has cut a path for all of us. And now the Lamb of God gets us past everything now. Just like that. This is worldwide. This is not Jesus Christ and his Father made all of the universe. So you can see that that is all going on right in front of us. The realm of the dead, the Xibaba. So that's what this whole Maze Runner show represents. Even coming out on the September 19th, this September month has a lot of connections with Saturn and with the devil and such, and with the beast from the bottomless pit that is released. And when the time of grace and mercy is over and Jesus shuts his door, there is not going to be any way to get through except if you think you can get through this realm of fear. And these things are actually released. See all of these things of the undead, like the locusts released, and these are spirits. These are all spirits that can actually take over people and possess them and things, and cause them to kill each other and prey upon your fear. Just like Freddy Krueger could manifest your nightmares and then put all upon you. Well, I just wanted to show that that's all right in front of us, and that's what this show represents. The maze coming, just like right here in the C notes. And we showed how he has this box. See Pinhead right here? I wanted to show this other thing too real quick. You see how 21 Jump Street? This show is all about the devil coming. Peter Pan, right here. You probably didn't know that that was actually him. See right here on Satan's webpage? This is right in Wikipedia. That's why I'm showing this right here, is how easy it is. Satan, right down here at the bottom, he's also called Pan. This whole show, 21 Jump Street, is about Satan trying to get away from judgment so that he won't be judged, because he's cast down for the day of judgment right here. This number 21, 22, and 23 are shown a lot. They had a Jump Street 21 and a Jump Street 22. And he's trying to escape judgment, just as we saw right there, that Satan is cast down on the day of judgment. Confess with your mouth, the Lord is Jesus. Believe in your heart, God hath risen him from the dead, and you'll be saved. Hallelujah. This one guy is also seen as Pinhead. See this? He's shown right over in Washington. Pinhead, Zipe Totec, from the Dark Rift, is shown as coming out of a box. Just like this right here. Here he is. That's what he looks like. Coming. To feed on fear. Right there, right in front of us. Like this skull, death. There's Washington, D.C., with him coming out of the box. Right there. Thank you very much, everybody. This is real and right in front of us all the time. Satan has a plan. He has even been mapping out the realm of the dead to try to escape when he is cast down for judgment. He wants to not be judged and escape judgment. Thank you very much, everybody. May Jesus Christ have mercy on us all. Hallelujah.